What is bandwidth? Gigabits per second, megabits per second, you've heard these terms. What is a bits per second? What are we even talking about? We are talking about sending signals and how quickly devices can send signals from one place to another and how fast that signal can get there. And so let's do it. Let's talk about what it looks like. And I'm going to show some examples here and we're going to send some signals. We're going to do it one bit at a time because often that is how it goes. Not always, but that's a topic for another video. So let's do that. Let's send some signals by flashing this light. When it's on, we're sending a one. When it's off, we're sending a zero. We're sending a binary signal. So if we flash this signal on and off, we can send yes, no, one, zero, binary signals. So how are we going to do this? We're going to send a bunch of signals and we're going to do it over time. So we have our timeline here at the bottom that indicates over time we are sending these signals. And every, let's say 1 second, just as a starting example, every 1 second we're going to send either a one with the light being on or a zero with the light being off. This is a binary signal. So if the light is off, it's a zero. If the light is on, it's a one. Let's say, for example, that we wanted to send this signal. This is one byte of binary, 10101110. That is our signal. How are we going to send that? What's it going to look like? It's going to look like we're flashing this light on and off. So we're going to start at time zero. Before we start, we're going to say we're at time zero. And let's blink that light on and off. And you can see as it blinks on and off, we're filling in the screen up on top. And our time periods are going by over here down at the bottom. We're gonna watch that one more time just so you can kind of get comfortable with it. Obviously you can rewind the video, but let's show this video one more time. So 1 0 1 0 1 1 1 0. That's our signal. And as we send that signal, we are sending one bit per second. Over 8 seconds, we can send 8 bits. That is 1 bit per second. That's how fast we are able to send it. That is the bandwidth of this communication channel. We are talking about sending 1 bit per second. Well, let's speed it up. Let's say we can go a little bit faster. We are able to read those signals a little bit faster. We get a little bit of practice with it, and we can watch that go by a little bit faster. So instead of 1 second, let's use a half second interval. We can send the same signal a lot faster. That signal goes a lot faster. Well, that's great. How much faster was it? Well, before we were at 1 bit per second, now we have 8 bits being sent over 4 seconds, or a total of 2 bits per second. That's great. We've doubled our bandwidth. Now let's go even faster. We can do it. We can go even faster than that. Let's go every 0.125 seconds. And be ready, because it's going to go by real quick. Do you see that? Do we need to do it again? I think we need to watch that one more time. Okay, you can see it goes a lot faster. As we can send those signals more quickly, we can send more bits per second. So now we had 2 bits per second. Now we've doubled and then doubled again our speed, and now we are at 8 bits per second. So now we're at 8 bits per second. That's probably pushing the limits of what my small human brain can process. But computers can obviously go much faster than that, and we're going to talk about some of those speeds in just a second. So bandwidth then is the maximum rate of data transfer across a given path or network, typically measured in bits per second. So you'll see bits per second referring to bandwidth often. Historically, it hasn't always meant that. It used to mean, and still in other fields, means other things relating to the frequency bands that things are being sent. But in the network context, frequently it's referring to bits per second. So how do computers do it? We were flashing lights on and off. That's not, well, I mean, I guess it kind of is. In a fiber optic connection, blinking lights on and off really fast is how those signals are sent. But an electrical connection, like your twisted pair Ethernet cable, that is being sent as electrical voltage. Not necessarily a very high voltage. In fact, it's a very low voltage. But it's being sent as changes in voltage across the wire. And the full physics and electromechanics of that are a topic for a future video. But very simplistically, just like with our blinking light, we needed to know how long each flash was going to be. Was being on for 1 second or a half second? Because if we don't know how long a one lasts or how long a zero lasts, we might double some of those signals or get messed up in some of our signals. So we have to have a clock that indicates what time we are referring to. And then you can send your ones as a voltage and zeros as an absence of voltage, for example. In reality, it's much more complicated than that, but again, that's going to be a topic for a separate video. But they do this incredibly, incredibly fast. How fast? We are talking kilobits per second, megabits per second, gigabits per second, possibly even terabits per second. So kilo means 1,000 bits per second. So at best, we got up to 8 bits per second. Kilobits per second is 1,000 of those. And old modem connections were, let's say, 56 kilobits per second. There were some that were even older than that, but let's say 56 kilobits per second. So 56,000 bits per second. That is, you know, those flashing lights, those pulses in electrical signal being sent 56,000 signals per second or bits per second. Megabits refers to millions. So a megabit per second is 1,000,000 bits per second. And let's say Cat5 Ethernet can support 100 megabits per second. That means 100,000,000 bits per second in those pulses of electrical signal. Gigabits per second, what we're looking at today in terms of, you know, modern network speeds are typically in the 1 to 10 to, you know, maybe 100 gigabit per second speeds. That is billions of bits per second. Billions of those changes in signals. And finally, you know, theoretically somewhere down the line, we're going to be looking at terabits per second or trillions of bits per second. So as we look at these increases in speed, we can see it's getting really fast. It's sending a lot of signals very, very quickly. And that is what those are referring to. It's the number of ones and zeros, the number of signals that can be sent in 1 second, bits per second. Now, one last thing before we close here, an important thing that you need to remember. A byte and a bit are not the same thing. A byte is 8 bits. So, and typically a byte is specified with a capital B and bits are specified with a lowercase b. So all of the speeds, the bits per second that we've been talking about is bits, not bytes. But often you will see your computer reporting times in bytes per second. So when you're downloading a file, it's often reported to you in how many bytes per second. So just remember that a byte is 8 bits. So if you multiply the bytes per second times 8, you'll get the bits per second. So if you're paying, let's say you're paying for a 1 gigabit per second internet connection, the fastest download that you can expect to see is 125 megabytes per second, because 1 gigabit is 125 megabytes because of that 8-to-1 ratio. So check yourself before you close, before you leave. Can you define what bandwidth is? And what does it mean to increase bandwidth? How do we do that? How do we increase bandwidth? And what does it mean when you're improving the bandwidth of a connection?